Hello everyone, welcome back to Yahya's Research. Today we are diving deep into the world of infrastructure project in India. Guys, infrastructure is always a vital component for any economic growth and the development of any nation, and India, as our study case, is no exception. However, there are several factors that influence the research and development of the infrastructure project in this case study, India, because India is diverse and also dynamic country. So let's explore these factors and discuss the possible solution to tackle them. Let's get started. First thing first, the first major factors that affects the research and development of infrastructure project in India is the aging and antiquated infrastructure. According to the report by Niti Aayog, India's infrastructure gap is estimated to be around 1.5 trillion. This means that there is a significant need for upgrading and modernizing the existing infrastructure. Some of the challenges faced include the congestion and also the inefficiency in transport networks. We can also mention about the inadequate power supply, the low coverage of water supply, and also the sanitation services. The limited access to digital infrastructure also plays a major role here, and also India has insufficient social infrastructure. This issue is not only will hamper the productivity and competitiveness of the economy, but it should also affecting the quality of life for the citizen of India. The next thing after the infrastructure, India also has a issue on corruption, just like the other developing country. Another factor that hinders the progress of this infrastructure project is the prevalence of corruption of their citizens, and also the faulty on the implementation models. Transparency international ranks India is 86 out of 180 countries in the corruption perception index. Corruption takes many forms, yeah, such as bribery, kickbacks, collusion, misuse of the funds, and also the fraud. This practice increasing the cost and also the time of runs of the project, and also compromise their quality and their sustainability. So to overcome this challenge, it is crucial to strengthen the anti-corruption mechanism and enforce the strict penalties for those involved in the corrupt practice. Next thing after the corruption, as we have mentioned before, is the alternative implementation model. So the adoption of the faulty implementation model also posed another challenge for infrastructure project in India. The traditional public sector model, relying on the budgetary allocation and also the public borrowing, that has been proven inadequate and inefficient to be used in India. Limited fiscal space, lack of technical expertise, and also delay in obtaining clearance, and also poor monitoring and evaluation system hinder the project execution in India. To address this issue, the alternative implementation model that could be right by India is public-private partnership, PPPs, hybrid annuity model, engineering-procurement-construction. Maybe India can also try the build-operate transfer, and so they could bring more efficiency, more innovation, and also more accountability to their project of infrastructure. The next thing, after the faulty implementation, financing also a critical aspect that determines the success or failure of any kind of infrastructure project. The high capital intensity and also the long gestation period coupled with a low return on investment make it combo on challenging to attract private investor to India. Lack of long-term and low-cost financing source, inadequate bond and also the equity market, plus high-risk perception further complicate the financing landscape. To overcome this challenge, I think India can develop a robust project pipeline that is providing the fiscal and also financial incentive, also establishing the specialized institution. Maybe they could also strengthen the regulatory framework. And of course, they need to enhance the capacity of public and private entities to be involved in any kind of infrastructure development. I think the last but not least is about the inflation pressure, especially after the COVID. Yeah, inflation pressure plays a significant role in any infrastructure project. The rising cost of the material, labor, equipment, increasing the input costs, while they are limited by the ability to revise the tariffs and fees in the land with the inflation, it could affecting revenue generation in the future. Demand elasticity, competition, and also the political constraint will also furthering the impact on profitability and the sustainability of the project. And to mitigate the impact of this inflation, I think adopting the mechanism such as indexation or escalation clause, maybe they could also find some hedging or insurance instrument, and maybe they should find put their money to diversification or bundling strategies that could be beneficial for the project, because most of the infrastructure project is multi-years, while the monetary and also the dynamics of the economics, we can never ever predicting the inflation. So maybe that brings us to the end of our exploration of those factors that affecting the research and development of infrastructure project in India, the aging infrastructure, the corruption, faulty implementation model, and also the financing pattern and inflation pressure is challenging India. So they need to be addressed to create a better future for them by upgrading and modernizing infrastructure. They could also strengthen anti-corruption measure. Also to mention that they should adopting innovative implementation models in attracting investment and managing their inflation. India need to do all of them if they want to achieve their vision of becoming 5 trillion economy by 2025 and becoming 26 trillion economy by 2050. Maybe that's all for me. Thank you for joining us today. Don't forget to like, share, and also subscribe to our channel for more exciting content. Until next time, guys, take care of yourself and always keep exploring something new.